Get ready to match the stars. Greg Morris. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Riley. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Fannie Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now here's the star of Match Game 76.
Don't you all look snappy?
Except you. You look elegant.
Elegant?
Elegant.
Oh, he's come.
Very
come.
Distinguished looking gentleman.
Thank you very much. And your name is.
Are you ready to meet our two players over here?
Yeah. Sure.
Well, then let's greet warmly Evelyn Collins and Faith Compton. Hello, ladies. How are you? Really? You shouldn't be nervous. You won $5,600. You got no right to be nervous. Money's supposed to calm you down, doesn't it?
Yeah, it will.
It will.
It will.
Okay. Now let's find out who this lady is and where she's from. Faith, nice to have you with us.
Thank you. I'm from Burbank, and I'm an executive secretary in Encino, and I'm happily single.
Happily single?
Yes.
That's the opposite of happy, though married, isn't it?
After Burbank, secretary. What was that?
Executive secretary, not an ordinary.
Oh, I thought you said something about sex.
No. They make over $20,000 a year.
No.
She doesn't make over $20,000 a year.
Oh, well, then good. She may play ball.
Yes. All right, Faith, we wish you the very best of luck. We will start this game in a moment or so, but right now we've got to do a little business with America. Hurry back. Hello there. You ready? Here we go. Bing. A or B, Faith?
B.
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 All right. New game everybody plays.
Oh.
The $6 million man said, I think the bionic woman transmits too much voltage. Every time she kisses me, sparks fly out of my blank. That's what the $6 million man said. I think the bionic woman transmits too much voltage. Every time she kisses me, sparks fly out of my blank.
I remember that. I think.
No, I'm sorry, you...
Pardon?
You can't. I will not introduce you to my daughter. I absolutely will not. I refuse.
She is a perfect combination of you and Helen.
Yes, she is. She is
really
our child.
Why don't we get her out here so all of America can see her?
Well, we'll do that. You ready over there? Okay. Here we go.
Come on, Ben. To make my explanation.
All right. The $6 million man said, Faith, I think the bionic woman transmits too much voltage. Every time she kisses me, sparks fly out of my blank.
Bionic eye.
My bionic eye. Every time she kisses me, sparks fly out of my eye.
I never watched.
You're not too thrilled with that, are you? Oh. Well, we'll see what happens here. Greg?
Well, he's a friend of mine. He's like a dragon, so I sit out of his nose.
Out of the nose. Sparks fly out of my nose. What'd you say to that?
You think they'd attack her like that if she were a married woman? I said, what did I say? What's that say, hon?
Ears.
Oh, thank you. Ears.
Ears is what you say. Bionic eye.
Ears.
Ears is what we're looking for. No, we're looking for eyes, not ears. Give us an eye.
Eye, I don't know.
Come on, give us an eye.
I said plugs.
Out of my plugs.
I didn't get an eye, but I got a laugh.
Weirdo. What do you say?
What does that say? Don't make her.
I'm
sorry, Faith.
She's won't speak for anyone, will she?
Yeah. Fannie, give us an eye, Fannie.
I can't. I've watched when Richard kisses all the girls in the audience, the sparks come out of their ears.
Out of their ears.
That's what I put down.
Well, eyes or ears, those are all good possibilities. Now let's see how Evelyn does with her first rounder. They're a little harder, as you know. Dumb Dora ruined her husband's shirts because when she ironed them, she didn't use a steam iron, she used a blank iron. Ruined her husband's shirts But when she ironed the shirt, she didn't use a steam iron. She used a blank iron.
Do you know that the other day I tried to put up or down or whatever one does when one folds an ironing board, and I couldn't do it?
Yes, they're fiendish things, aren't they?
And my children attacked me.
Oh, really?
They said I was no damn good.
Your kid said that.
They said, how can you be a mother and not know how to put up an ironing board? I said, I don't believe iron.
You should bring these stories out in hardcover for Christmas. They are so enchanting.
Out in hardcover for Christmas, you.
They are adorable. Julie Andrews can do it, so can you.
Evelyn, dumb Dora ruined her husband's shirts because when she ironed them, she didn't use a steam iron, she used a blank iron.
Flat iron.
A flat iron.
No, that is...
No.
Well, that would be a conventional iron, you see. The old-fashioned flat iron kind that you put on the gas stove, right, and then you spit on the shirts and then you iron them the way that...
That's what I have!
Is that what you have? What did you say, Greg?
It's on the stove.
Flat iron.
Well, I think she is from Texas, so I said a Brandon iron.
A Brandon iron is a good answer. That'd ruin a shirt, wouldn't it, Brett?
I figured she used an andiron.
An andiron. That's another good answer. All good answers, but no match.
I got a big farm, Gene, up in near San Francisco.
So I said branding iron, too.
You did, too. All right. All right. Branding iron's good. What do you say, Elaine?
They were just running rampant with branding iron.
Yep. She didn't use a steam iron. She used a flat iron, according to Evelyn. That's what she's after. A flat iron.
Well, of course, if I put my answer that way, it would...
Be flat.
Would you accept that? Oh, sit on a branding iron.
Tell him, Richard, don't take no guff from nobody.
What enough guff.
That's all. I'm sorry.
Everybody had branding iron.
Yeah.
Well, that was a good one. Curling iron would have been good, too. So there we are at the end of round one. No score, but don't worry. It can get worse than this. We'll have another round or so in a minute. But, here we go. Round two coming up, ladies. There it is. A and B and Faith, it's up to you.
I'll go with B again.
Faith, it's up to you, Faith. Faith, it's up to Faith. Everybody plays.
Goody.
Count Dracula said.
Here we go again.
You all know the hit record with the song in my heart.
Yeah.
Do you know that song?
Yeah.
Sure. Well, the number one hit in Transylvania is with a blank in my heart.
I believe I've got it.
You are the perfect person.
Nobody's perfect.
You are perfect. Ah!
I'm sorry.
You guys are animals.
I didn't need to that. I gotta go to the...
What do you mean we are animals?
No.
It was wonderful. That was really good.
Now I'm coming to the best part.
Go ahead, Richard. He's right there.
I am the best part.
Put something on the card.
With a blank in my heart.
The number one song hit in Transylvania is with a blank in my heart.
Yeah, gotcha.
Okay.
Very good, Elaine.
Thank you.
Contractor said, you all know the hit record with a song in my heart? Well, the number one hit in Transylvania is... The number one hit in Transylvania is with a blank in my heart.
With a knife in my heart.
With a...
Oh, my God.
You are not familiar with Count Dracula. Are you familiar with the tradition? You will find out in a moment.
What do you say, Greg?
Oh, well, that's kind of strange. I said with a stake in there.
Stake. And they had to kill him with a stake.
That's the only way you can kill them, darling. They don't die with a knife.
See?
Oh,
you act as...
With a stake in my heart.
What do you say?
Oh, yes.
What do I say?
Yes.
I say, with a stake in my heart. I'm going to get caught.
Get the net.
Don't call us, we'll call you. Charles.
Thank you.
You should do a Christmas album as well. I had a lot of dental work, so I said with a fang in my heart.
With a fang in my heart is good. All right. Faith is looking for a knife in her heart. She forgot that Count Dracula was killed with a stake in the heart. What do you say?
I kept thinking of heartburn and all those things and stake. Maybe this is right. I said with a stab in my heart.
With a stab in my
knife
heart.
Stab?
By Joe. There's one for Faith. With a stab in my heart. Richard?
I left my stake
in San Francisco.
Oh, you did? What do you say?
Steak.
Steak was the answer. So Faith has won. And Evelyn, it looks like you're in the driver's seat. All you got to do is one to tie and two to win. Is that easy? Is that easy, Evelyn?
Should be.
Should be easy. Okay. Here we go.
Okay.
Ready?
Did she take A or B?
Unlucky Louie said... She took the only one that was left.
Oh, I see.
Unlucky Louie said, I just bought one of those pens that writes on butter. Just my luck. I got to write on blank. You're looking at me as if you don't understand this question.
I understand it, and you know what? I'm not only do I understand it, I'm going to give the definitive answer, and I defy anyone to deny.
That's it.
Is that the definitive answer?
Well, in my if I were playing,
every once in a while, you luck out.
Yes. Okay. There we go. Everybody ready? Evelyn Collins. Unlucky Louie said, I just bought one of those pens that writes on butter. Just my luck. I've got to write on...
Margarine.
That's a good answer.
She gave a good answer. Greg, what do you say?
Hooray for Olio.
Olio. That's one. Score is tied. One more, Evelyn, and you win the game. Brett?
Is that true?
That's true.
I say, Margarine Morningstar.
Margarine, did you win the game? What the rest of you have? By here for a moment or so while we say goodbye to Faith Compton. It was a pleasure to meet you.
It was a pleasure being here.
And we've got many gifts for you, Faith Compton. A memento of your trip here to Match Game 76. Goodbye, my dear.
Thank you.
Whoops. Stand on the tape. Put the stand on the tape. How do you feel?
Fine.
Good. Here it is again, Evelyn. You got $5,700 and you could win. You could go over $10,000 if you go all the way here. Shall we begin? We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Martin Blank. Now, the answer that group of people gave most frequently is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the middle one, you get $250, and then the bottom one gets you $100. And let's see what kind of help you'll get from our celebrities.
All right, Richard.
Ow! Let me think. Oh, Lola. Martin and Lewis.
Martin and Lewis. Okay, there's one.
Two explorers, dear. They were in Africa. You probably read about it in the paper then.
Martin Luther King.
Martin Luther King's one.
Charles.
That was mine. What, Martin? Martin.
It's not a good. Not bad. Well, wait a minute, hon.
Third
is tough.
Wait a minute. I have to stamp your ticket. Now you can get back in again.
Martin Landau.
Martin Landau. Okay, so you got Martin Landau, Martin Luther King, and Martin and Lewis. Do you want one of those, Evelyn, or do you want to choose one of your own?
I want one of those. I thought of Martin Luther King.
Okay, let's find out if he's up there, and if so, where. We begin down at the bottom as we usually do and reveal the $100 response. Martin Luther King, congratulations, you got it right off the bat. Just for curiosity's sake, what's under the $250 number?
Martin Milner.
Milner?
And we've had him on this show, too, haven't we?
Yeah.
All right, and let's see what we've got on the big one.
Ow!
Oh!
I made it. Soon they forget.
Yeah.
So,
Martin and Lewis is under the big one, and there you go. Now, you're going to play for 10 times that $100 or $1,000, but first we've got to do a little business with America, and this is it. Here we are with Evelyn Collins. She's got $5,800. She's going to try now for $1,000 because she just won $100 in the audience match here. Now, two. Collect the $1,000. You've got to match one of them exactly.
Richard, please.
Okay, here we go.
Charlie won for you the last time, Evelyn.
Look, we had a fight. You got to bring it up on the air. It's over. We broke up.
I'm sorry, I didn't know you had a fight.
There was a lot of hours between his shows.
Okay, Richard, you ready? Here we go. You look at me. Okay? Are you thinking about Richard?
Mm-hmm.
You really got your thoughts?
She's probably thinking about that fight she had with Charles.
Oh, yeah. Here it is. Stewed blank. S-T-E-W-E-D. Stewed blank. All right, he's finished, Evelyn. What answer do you want to give us? What you think will match his? Stewed blank.
Prunes.
Prunes. She said prunes, Richard.
Funny fruit.
It is the funny fruit. They're so wrinkled and goofy looking there.
Never thought you would say that, dear.
You never thought she'd say stewed prunes?
No, although I did.
Yes. You now have $6,800. Good for you. And I know you're very happy. Let's go right in now and swing into another game with Terry Gerber. You ready for her? Here we go. For him. Her. Yeah. Hello. Well, there you are. He's too much. Terry Gerber, we welcome you.
Well, thank you.
Did you get your card?
Yes, dear.
Oh, dear. Terry Gerber. So you're Terry Gerber.
I certainly am.
Yes. Have you ever been anyone else?
Not that I can remember.
Yes. Where do you live, Terry?
I live right here in L.A.
Okay.
L.A.
And what do you do here? Yeah.
I hope to be doing some acting in town soon.
Mm-hmm. I think you're going to
want
be.
Wants to, yes, act?
Yes.
My card.
Charles is in women's wear.
This is... Anything else you want to tell us about Terry Gerber?
Sports nut all the way around.
Oh, good for you. Good luck to you here, Terry. We'll begin now by asking you to make a selection. You may have A or B.
B.
B it is? Okay. Fickle.
Well, of course, I'm leaving this business, getting into sports, so let's get on with this.
Yesterday, you were trying to get my daughter's phone number to have a date with her. Today, you're trying to get Terry Gerber's phone number.
Yep.
You are fickle.
I never denied that. But I have a good time.
Grog the caveman was so absent-minded, first he walked his girlfriend, then he tried to blank his dinosaur.
Oh, now you're going to have to do that one more time, sweetie.
Grog the caveman was so absent-minded, first he walked his girlfriend, then he tried to blank his dinosaur.
Oh, well, now you see.
The presumption here is that the dinosaur... Well, I won't go that far. With a dinosaur?
Very tricky little devil.
They are tricky. Walked his girlfriend, and he tried to blank his dinosaur.
Oh, yeah.
Right, okay.
Lovely tune.
Yeah, what is that? Play that a little louder.
Oh, yeah, they don't ride him like that anymore.
Music.
You like it?
That's music for dead people.
You ready, Terry?
The battle hymn of South Korea.
That's right. Grog the caveman was so absent-minded, first he walked his girlfriend, then he tried to blank his dinosaur.
Make love, too.
Make love, too. That's what she said. Got all mixed up there. Greg, what do you say to that?
That's terrible.
Really?
Dinosaur, man. I mean, that's a big dude.
I know it.
Well, he's got a very small head.
But Grog was dumb, so he tried to make love to the dude.
He tried to make love to him. Must have took him a week. What do you say?
You know, dinosaurs' little heads were so small, that's why they disappeared off the face of the earth.
Because it was dumb.
Because they were so dumb, but they weren't so dumb they couldn't whoopee it up.
Whoopee it up? That's two for Terry. Two for Terry. What do you say, Charles?
It's going to be a very interesting response.
You wish.
I said dehorn.
Dehorn? They didn't even have
horns. I haven't torn up an answer in a long time, but that does it.
They don't even have horns. Elaine, what do you say?
I'm going to say it fast because they got signs up here. Kiss.
Kiss. All right.
The animal got into television. It was called the Diner Shore Show. I said love.
Yeah. Okay, there it is.
Make love.
Make love. There's another one. So that's four for you. And you're going to come along later. But right now, this for you. Pay attention. Next time when we get together, these are the celebrities who will be on this very stage.
Bill Daly, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lee Meriwether, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
How about them apples? Join us for Match Game 76. Goodbye.